Hi, and welcome back to Ask a Pennsylvania Dutchman. My name is Chris LaRose, and this here is Douglas Maidenford, our resident Pennsylvania Dutchman. Was hast du zu sagen?
Ich hab nichts zu sagen. I don't got nothing to say until I hear the question.
Uh-huh, that's never true.
Do we got a question?
He's got a lot to say, whether somebody's there to listen or not.
That's right.
He keeps going. All right. Well, we got a question from Steve of Somerset, Ohio.
I didn't know
there was a Somerset.
There's a Somerset, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, that's the only one that
that's
I know.
That's the only one that counts.
Yeah.
All right, moving on.
All right, wow, that's harsh.
Wait, words.
All right, here we go.
What's Steve want to know?
Well, Steve says, hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi, Steve.
All good questions start with
a greeting. Yeah.
All right. We are involved in a long ongoing debate here regarding the differences between cucumbers and pickles.
Okay.
Some of us are from Pennsylvania, some are from Michigan, and some are from Ohio. We are hoping you could help put an end to our differences. Several call the actual seeds, plants, and product a pickle, while the rest claim you plant cucumber seeds, grow and harvest cucumbers, and make pickles out of them. What would the Pennsylvania Dutchman say? Any help is appreciated. Steve, Somerset, Ohio.
So we're going to end a long-lasting debate, according to Steve. That's a lot of pressure.
I don't know if I'm ready for that. That's some
but nothing is. I've heard of stupid debates, and then I've heard of
this
debates
is a serious,
like this. This is a serious question.
Issue. I don't know, Doug. We ended a debate about pot pie, and then that went.
Whoop. Well, this is probably going to be one we're going to get hate mail on again. And you know what?
We're brave. We'll do it. We're going to tackle this.
We got
issue.
Broad shoulders.
Yeah,
sort of.
Yeah,
figuratively. All right. My initial response is this. It depends what language you're speaking.
You're skirting.
Is that a cop-out? I don't think so. For me, personally, if I'm speaking personally, in English, the plant and the seed and what the plant grows or produces is a cucumber.
Mm-hmm.
And then you turn it into a pickle.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
That's what I think. Now, in Pennsylvania Dutch, we don't have a word for cucumber and pickle. It's the same word for both.
Mm.
It's a gummer. And the plural is gummer. Now, how you then tell the difference between, like, and this is another great debate we can throw at him. So, in the answer to, I mean, do you agree with that?
When you speak
English, is that what you did growing up? You had cucumbers,
mm-hmm.
and then you had pickles. They were two different things.
To be honest, I still don't know the difference, so I'm waiting for your answer.
The difference is a pickle is a cucumber that's been pickled.
Yeah,
it's gone through the process of pickling.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Now, there's different kinds of pickles.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's where we can get into the big debate.
The good kind.
But I'm going to answer that question. The first question is, yes, cucumber is the seed, the plant, and the fruit. I guess it's a fruit. I don't know. Or a vegetable. I always get that mixed up. The seed's on the inside, so that makes it a fruit. I don't know. What about
strawberries? Their seeds are in the outside.
Yeah, I know.
Well, they're
I know.
A fruit, too.
Tomatoes are fruit.
Oh, but my God.
Anyway, that's the cucumber, and you then pick that, and if you eat it raw on a salad, then it's cucumber. But when you pickle it, then it becomes a pickle. That's my answer
but
to that question.
But they're still raw, so what if you
no,
eat a pickle that's raw?
No, not necessarily. No.
Oh, my gosh. Doug, come
now,
on.
Now, there are tons of different kinds of pickles out there, too. Now, among the Pennsylvania Dutch, I think the two most common would be dill pickles
mm-hmm.
and what I grew up calling bread and butter pickles.
Oh,
which
those are
like
my favorite. Those
sweet.
Are the best.
They're a sweet pickle. Some people, and that's a big debate for some people. Some people
love. Did you
have
pickle sandwiches as a kid?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Some people had, some people only eat bread and butter. Some people only eat dill, and they won't cross paths. And then you got people like me. I'll eat any kind of pickle. You know, it always reminds me of my favorite joke. Well, not my favorite joke, but a joke I like.
What's
the best part of a sandwich?
What's that?
The pickle.
It's not even on there.
Not always, but it's there. I love pickles. I could sit and eat pickles like a pregnant woman. Isn't that some pregnant women? Don't they always like crave pickles?
I don't know.
Maybe Yeah, I've heard that before.
You've had kids? What's the answer?
I don't think my wife craved pickles.
Well, what did she crave?
I don't remember.
Was it chocolate or something?
She always craves chocolate. It doesn't matter. Do you eat both kinds of pickles?
I do, yeah. Are all, anyway. Well,
yeah, you know, I met, well, speaking of my wife, she and her family introduced me to a kind of pickle I'd never had before.
What's that?
They call them icicle pickles, and then I was talking to somebody
else.
There's
no such thing.
No, and then I heard.
That's not real. No, they're real.
And some people call them 14-day pickles, because I guess they pickle
they
for 14.
Just hang off your gutters out in the
winter? Right. Yeah, you do that in the winter. It's like ice
wine. Break a pickle off.
No, I'll tell you what, they're pretty good. It's like a sweet pickle, but it's not bread and butter. It's a little different. And that talking about Pennsylvania Dutch language, we would say, so if we have, I said that cucumber and pickle are the same word, goma. But if you had bread and butter pickles on the table, they'd be called sea skumra, sweet pickles, and dill gumra, dill pickles. Dill is the same word in Pennsylvania Dutch and in German too, as in English. So, if I had to choose between the two, let's say we're sitting here and a bowl of each is on this table and you could only pick one.
Bread and butter pickles.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
No, I would pick dill every day of the week.
Religion?
If I only had to pick one. I like bread and butter, but sometimes I can eat a bucket full, not a bucket. I can eat a bowl full of dill pickles, but a bowl full of bread and butter is a little too much.
Yeah, well, you don't eat them on a whole bowl. You eat a bread and butter sandwich.
Well, no, I know, but
sometimes good things are in moderation, Doug. You can't just have the whole bowl.
That's overrated.
Sometimes
moderation is overrated. But I really like cucumbers, too. I love cucumber salad. Simple Pennsylvania Dutch dish. You take your cucumber, you slice it, and if you're an onion person, you can throw some raw onions in there. Vinegar, water, and sugar. Salt, pepper. Mix that up, let it sit on the as a side dish on the table. Hari, as is. You can't get better eating than that. Fresh from the garden.
I think pickles ought to get more credit. And cucumbers, they're like the real diet.
Yeah, and you know what you can else make out of pickles? Relish.
Mm-hmm.
Now, who doesn't like relish on a hot dog? Hari yama. That's good eating.
I mean, I think we ought to.
I really, you know.
But what?
I hope that we solve this guy's debate. I mean, if he's gonna take our word as gospel, which more people should, then it's two different things. There's a cucumber turns into a pickle.
What's a pickle turn into?
Into my gut. That's where it goes, because I love pickles. We'd make pickles every year.
I've never had one of them.
Oh, I'll get you some pickles.
Do you have any today?
Yeah, I have pickles.
Oh, hot diggity dog.
They're in the cold cellar with the other,
Here I was shooting videos. I didn't think I was getting food, too.
You'll get fed.
Woo.
We got pickles.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Well,
what's your favorite pickle? Well, we know. He's a bread and butter kind of guy.
Mine's free pickles.
Yeah, anything that's free. I like dill. Kosher dill, and whatever. You know, let us know. Tell us about your fight in your family. Maybe your family fights over pickles, too. There could be a lot worse things for a family to fight over than pickles.
Yeah, like,
right? I mean, if that's all your family's fighting over in this day and age,
that's nothing.
That's congratulations to you. My family can't sit down at the table and talk. There's a lot of things that are off the table at the Maiden Ford family when we get together. You know, politics, that kind. You can't talk about that stuff. But if all you're arguing over is pickles in 2019...
You're blessed. That's good news.
Good on you.
Yeah.
Keep it up.
Pickles for peace.
Pickles for peace.
All right. Well, you heard it from the
Would it be like if we had like a picture of like a pickle and then, you know, like get flashing the peace sign, like if you had little arms?
That'd be... Yeah, two little tiny pickles for fingers.
But are you... See, now that... Then is it slices or spears?
What do you
or whole
mean?
Pickles.
Spears.
Like, you
can't
know, like,
have pickles for peace and have pickle spears. You gotta have, you know, slices.
Oh, yeah. Well, I guess you have to be a little slice.
Yeah,
a little slice of pickle.
You gotta be, you know, friendly.
What if it was the whole pickle? Like, the whole cucumber's been pickled.
Well.
You know, like those little gherkins.
Yeah.
And he's got little, like, stick arms and a
flash
of the sun.
Yeah, so it's the whole cucumber and he's got
Somebody draw that up and post that underneath
in
the comments.
Yeah, so we're
Pickles for Pete.
This is for the National Pickles for Pete rally piece that we're rallying.
Well, maybe
doing.
There's a... We gotta look at what day of the year is National Pickle Day. You know it exists.
Oh, yeah.
It exists.
I think we ought to start, like I was going to say, I think we ought to start like a big festival, pickle festival. Does that
I'll
exist?
I'll bet you that exists, too. If you know where the pickle festival is,
if there's a pickle fest,
let us know.
We're
and
going.
If it's within driving distance, maybe we'll come.
Yeah.
I won't turn down a pickle.
No, nobody would.
I've driven farther for less.
Yeah, you know, sometimes I work at the Renaissance Fair.
Yeah.
If you're ever coming to the Renaissance Fair,
the Pennsylvania Renaissance Fair.
Yeah. I work at the Maze. Come swing by, say hi.
Yeah, yeah.
But you know, I've heard people say that they came just there for the pickles. They sell big pickles
on a stick, don't they?
Yeah, yeah.
They're huge.
Mm-hmm. They're massive. Yeah, and they got spicy ones like jalapeno.
Oh yeah, like hot pickles and stuff.
But you know, I was saying, people show up just for those. So obviously. Love of pickles is all over the world. It's a big deal. So
yeah, who doesn't like pickles?
Nobody.
Seriously.
Pickles
if
for
you
peace.
Know someone that doesn't like pickles, you don't need that negativity in your life.
Mm-mm.
You don't. Yeah. Now we're gonna make some more people angry.
Oh gosh, yeah. All right. Well, anyway, you heard it from the Dutchman.
Dill is the way to go.
No, I'm not bread and butter pickles.
Keep those questions coming, otherwise what the heck are we going to do here? Just
I mean,
argue
they're
about
like
pickles.
Dessert
no,
pickles, duh.
That's what bread and butter is. Bread and butter or dessert pickles?
I know. Who wants to have dinner first?
I don't
want to
fight over this.
You know, I grew up, I was somebody that always ate dessert first, because you never know if you're going to make it to dinner.
If you're going to make it to dessert?
Yeah, yeah.
What the heck kind of house did you grow up in that you didn't think you'd make it to dessert?
Well, you never know, Doug.
Life's too short, right?
Life's too short to eat dessert last. So eat that bread and butter pickle first, and then save the one that you can eat a bucket of later for afterwards when you know you got the good stuff in first.
I won't argue with you. I agree.
It's like retire when you're in your 20s and then work when you're...
Yeah. Yeah, if only it was that way.
Alright, well, you heard it from the Dutchman.
Pickles for peas.
Pickles for peas. Yeah. Until...
Go ahead.
Next time.
Mock's good. Why, if you have a question, why now you have to email us at bustapa@yahoo.com.